Reveal your secrets, fruit machine.
Эй, wake up, come on!
Ой, дебил!
Yes, Борис!
Здесь мистер Бокс from my context at the border. Let's see what type of contraband is hidden inside. Is definitely working. Maybe. Is there some kind of power switch? Опа! Battery light is broken. Not good sign. What type of keyboard is this? It's German, I should have guessed. From the distinct smell of air freshener coming from the fans. I can only assume this guy likes to live in his car a lot. Let's do quick battery endurance test. 3, 2, 1. Good. Typical gaming laptop battery endurance in 2020.
Ohoho, hello.
Reveal your secrets, mystery box.
It doesn't even work.
A piece of junk.
There has got to be something. God, here launch. Опа! What, that's it? Basic calculator and watch with no hand.
Птичьи, Zion forces of Uganda, блять.
Wait, hold on. The watch is Amsterdam.
But where is this Cupertino? Блин, what are you so happy about?
Oh, so this what the internet was like in 2008. A bit more boring than I remember.
And YouTube does not even load. Go.
Wait, I have an idea.
This will fix all your problems.
What am I doing?
Ha ha! Hackerman Boris.
Forget fruit OS. We have...
of course, might as well.
Of course, normal behavior is too much to ask for. But you not play along with Boris.
Boris, пригон, то есть, сука!
Толик алкоголик, иногда он ёлки колет. У него есть дружок Жорик, они вместе пиздоболят.
First thing we need to do is set the maximum time of the internal screen recorder length 0. Ah shit. So once that is done, we can start. We should just listen. Welcome to web developing lesson 2. Titled yes we can. We will program on calculator if we need. And today we are utilizing scrapped Western technology to learn CSS. In previous video, we learned HTML. I will write some HTML as an example, so we have summer to start from. Let's write home of Boris in the body. If you have no idea what is going on, please go check the previous video. It is in description. Now we have saved as HTML file. We open it up in favorite browser. Right click and choose inspect element to see better what is going on. If you still have your HTML from previous lesson, use that. And we come to the main part of this video, where we calm down, start explaining, and editor of this video, me, will put on some nice calming music as I explain what the blin is CSS.
No, forget about the music, that was a bad idea. CSS is horrible.
CSS is like having headache when you wake up in the morning, and it only gets worse in the day. In end of day you feel better again.
But you need it again in the morning.
That is the basic learning curve of CSS. Good fun when you're starting off, but could be a very big headache if you're working on big project. Let me show you. Now CSS defines what the web page looks like. They are called style sheets. Or more specifically, cascading style sheets. CSS, you see? Let me show you. Let's create a new file, write some random garbage inside, save in the same folder as your HTML file, and name it style.css. Now you will need to attach the CSS file to your HTML file, otherwise the styles will not work. In your HTML document, in the head tag, write link, then rel equals style sheet, just like this. Rel means relation or relationship, meaning what type of relation this link document should have with your HTML file. And this is exactly why we write style sheet, to tell the HTML document to use the contents of the CSS file to use as style. Now we write href, which if you remember from previous lesson, is the way we actually link something.
Good.
Now in this quotation marks we write the name of the file we just made. Yes, you can name it whatever you want. Okay, now save your HTML file, switch to your browser and reload, and you will see that nothing actually happened. This just means there is no style in the style sheet file. But if you scroll down, you will see in the head tag there is a link to the correct file. Nice. Open the CSS file in your text editor, remove whatever garbage is inside, and we can finally start writing some beautiful, beautiful CSS. So it works like this. You write something you want to target. Let's say we want to target the whole body tag and everything that is inside. Write curly bracket, leave some space, and close the bracket. Now inside this bracket go the actual style. And one line of style, it looked like this. The attribute you want to change, let's see background color. And next to it a value. And end with semicolon. Get this one style on one element. Save the document, go to browser, hit refresh. And it is done! You're hired! Welcome to world of web development. Now just wait for job offer to start rolling in. You think I'm joking? I'm not joking. The amount of programmer jobs out there, shit. You'll be lucky to finish watching this video before you get hired. But let's try anyway. Color means color of text within this element. Let's write white because it stands out on blue background. Save, switch to browser, reload, and the whole text is white. Nice! Try this yourself. Write more text in the body tag in your HTML file. Save, reload, see what happens. But me, I'm getting an idea. Why have random text floating around when we can put it in H1 tag? We covered this in HTML video, go check it out. So H1 by default is the largest heading. This means without adding actual styles, the text within the tag will become very big. If you scroll down to element inspector, we can see the H1. If you click on it, we can see all the styles that apply to this element. Sorry about the lag, I'm literally recording this on a piece of cheese. So this small window lets you modify styles temporarily. So you can uncheck this color box and then switch back to default color. But let's say you want to make permanent changes, not temporary. Go to your style sheet file, go to new line outside of the last brackets, and since the H1 is located within the body, we can target more accurately. Write body, space, H1, and brackets. Now everything you write in these brackets only applies to H1 element in the body tag. Let's write color yellow and line with semicolon. Save the file, switch to browser, refresh and the text is yellow. Try this at home, add some text outside of the H1 tag but within the body tag. And watch the color change. Or not, haha! Now go down to this section. You see your new styles being represented. This is target you just wrote and the color you chose. And now if you temporarily disable this color, the heading instead of switching back to the default color of black stays white. But why is that? It's because in CSS file you still leave the body color to white. And that is the most basic, the most simple explanation of the cascading part of style sheet. And this line overrides the color of H1. But this line still applies, although it is invisible. But doesn't that mean I can override shit indefinitely? Yes, it does. Let me show you. Let's say you want to override the style of H1 within the body tag. You write the same target, but this time a different color. So what color will heading be? Of course it is orange. Because in rules of CSS, the style.com letter is applied. This means if we switch these targets around, first comes orange and then yellow, then because they are targeting same thing, then this is applied because it comes later in the document of CSS. Just like that. But if one of these targets is shorter than another one, let's say we just target H1 instead of body H1, and yes, this is also correct, this is normal. Then which color do you think is applied? The shorter or the longer target? And the answer is the longer one. And even though it comes later in the document, it is always overwritten by the more accurate, the more longer, the more precise target. And that is the cascading part of style sheets. Whew! But why am I still using lighting? This is horrible. Oh, much better now. So let's add light. Paragraph of text, one link here, and we already have one small problem. Paragraph text is white, which is good, but link is invisible. That is because default color of links is always blue, and links have to be always overwritten from the general style, because the browser that is making them blue by default is already targeting only the links with the blue color, so you have to override. But paragraph, much more simple. A paragraph will take its color from the parent element, which in this case is the body element, which means, as you already saw, the paragraph text is already white. But let's say we want to add more space under paragraph. This is called a margin. And if you write margin-bottom, and for example 60 pixels, then it will add 60 pixels of space. And now that is a professional looking website. A heading, text, a link to go- well, nowhere, because I'm not connected to internet. I'm not stupid, what you think this is? Yeah, we're running a waste of space technology here. I not want some GPS to pinpoint my location. And neither do the people at NordVPN, because they know what they're doing. And they're also sponsors of today's video. They have been and will be keeping me safe for years to keep anonymity of Boris the Staff King alive. Forever. What do you think alternative is? I go around the internet clicking on suspicious links very carefully. No. It's VPN, man! Check link in description nordvpn.com/lifeofboris and get limited Black Friday deal with 2-year plan get 4 months off is not bad! I mean, realistically. Do you expect me to connect to public Wi-Fi in gas station in middle of Murmansk, Russia? Well, yes. With NordVPN is no problem. I try to find worst looking gas station in whole city. Go, connect, chat with friends, no problem. Watch some YouTube videos, check my email, and I still feel safe because VPN is encrypting all my traffic. And I'm connecting from South Africa. Good luck tracking me! Ah! And sometimes, you know, I just like checking out local Google searches. So, whatever your reason, shady websites or not, check out NordVPN. Take your offer 4 months for free on 2-year deal. NordVPN.com/ifworries and enjoy your privacy. But for now, I say thank you for watching. Next time, I will teach you even more about the magic of web development. And maybe, just maybe, we check out JavaScript and how to really take control of the browser. Stitching, Bricky. I'll see you next time.